We get the story from this week's hymn, straight from the hymn writer's mouth. This is one by Fanny Crosby. This is from Memories of 80 Years, an autobiography that she did in the early 1900s. She wrote this song in 1869, and this is the story of it. As I was addressing a large company of working men one hot August evening, the thought kept forcing itself upon my mind that some mother's boy must be rescued that very night, or perhaps not at all. So I requested that if there was any boy present who had wandered away from mother's teaching, he would come to the platform at the conclusion of the service. A young man of 18 came forward and said, "Did you mean me? I have promised my mother to meet her in heaven, but as I am now living, that will be impossible." We prayed for him. He finally arose with a new light in his eyes and exclaimed triumphantly, "Now I can meet mother in heaven, for I have found her God." A few days before that, her writing partner, Howard Doane, had sent her a title called Rescue the Perishing. She says, "While I sat there that evening, the line came to me, rescue the perishing, care for the dying. I could think of nothing else that night. When I arrived at my home, I went to work on it at once. And before I retired, the entire hymn was ready for melody." She sent it to Mr. Doane, and he wrote the beautiful and touching music as it now stands. She goes on to say, "In November 1903, I went to Lynn, Massachusetts to speak before the Young Men's Christian Association. I told him the incident that led me to write Rescue the Perishing as I have just related it. After the meeting, a large number of men shook hands with me, and among them was a man who seemed to be deeply moved. You may imagine my surprise when he said, 'Miss Crosby, I was the boy who told you more than 35 years ago that I had wandered from my mother's God. That evening that you spoke at the mission, I sought and found peace and have tried to live a consistent Christian life ever since. If we never meet again on earth, we will meet up yonder.' As he said this, he raised my hand to his lips, and before I had recovered from my surprise, he had gone and remains to this day a nameless friend who touched a deep chord of sympathy in my heart. It is these notes of sympathy that vibrate when a voice calls them from the dim memories of the past, and the music is celestial." Well, Fanny Crosby and that young man are together now as a result of her being willing to listen to God. I think many times we don't have a clue how close we are to being the voice, maybe somebody's last chance, somebody's best chance to hear about Jesus. It is our job. It is our duty, after we know about Jesus, to rescue the perishing.
Forgive if they all
human heart, crushed by the tempter. Feelings lie buried that grace can restore. Touched by a loving heart, wakened by kindness, chords that were broken will vibrate once more. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful. Let's all do our part this week to rescue the perishing. Don't be a stranger.